This is Not Her, a Camille Grace mystery, book 4. Written by Kate Bold. Narrated by Laura Covarrubias. Chapter 1. Megan could swear the frogs were laughing at her. She had been fighting with this knot for about 15 minutes now, and she couldn't get the damn thing to fit snugly. The pontoon boat bobbed patiently in the water beside her, but the frogs seemed to chuckle every time her failed knot unraveled from the dock. Night was falling, and she had no idea where Julie was. Julie had left to get the truck about 5 minutes ago, laughing under her breath about the trouble Megan was having with the knot. Julie had been in no shape to try to tie it down, because she'd had far too much to drink and could barely even walk without leaning against her boy of the week, much less tie a borrowed pontoon boat to a dock. Off in the distance, the frogs continued to laugh. It was a low, throaty sort of noise that echoed through the trees, across the lake, and straight to Megan's ears. Somewhere else, she thought she could hear a family laughing together. They were probably done with their day of fun on the lake and ready to head home for a nice dinner. Nearby, a fish jumped and broke the surface of the water, splashing back down in it. It was all very quaint, very pleasant, except for the fact that failing to tie this knot was making her feel like an idiot. She could manage a basic one, but she knew it needed to be strong, one of those knots only practiced Boy Scouts or woodsmen could make. It really sucked, because before this, it had actually been a fairly great day. Her day on the lake with her friends had gone better than she'd expected. It hadn't been the relaxing vacation she'd been looking for, but it had been nice. She would have rather gone to the beach, or maybe even to Atlantic City. Hell, maybe even Disney World. How they'd ended up outside of New Orleans on the pontoon boat of a man she didn't even know was beyond her. Then again, she'd had a few drinks, had flirted with some cute and very gullible guys, and got her tan a bit darker. And if she could just tie this stupid knot, there might be more drinks and a foolish night with a strange guy back at the hotel. She wouldn't be able to fault Julie and bitch at her in the morning, but she'd be fine with that. Griping at Julie was great and all, but so was a bit of drunken, no-tie sex. Plus, she still had one day left before she had to go back to Dallas. Back to home and back to work. She may as well make the most of it and enjoy the little time she had left. Finally, after what felt like forever, Megan got a very sturdy knot to cinch up tight. She wasn't sure, but she thought it was called a bow tie knot. She had no idea how she knew this. It was just one of those things she'd read or seen somewhere that had glued itself to her memory. Whatever it was holding the pontoon in place for the owner to pick back up, and it was holding strong. She took a moment to admire the knot and started to walk down the dock to join Julie and the guys back at the parking lot. It was odd how something as funny as properly tying a convoluted knot could make her feel so much better. Smiling, she decided maybe she'd have several more drinks and catch up to Julie. She'd do nothing without her cooler. And her cooler was back on the boat. She turned around and headed back to the pontoon, which was being held in place beautifully by her very strong knot. She hopped onto the boat just as she noticed a smaller boat pulling in behind her. It was a good distance away, its engine purring softly. It was coming directly for the pontoon, though, the speed decreasing and the engine dying down a bit. There was a single man on board, guiding it carefully to the rear of the pontoon. Megan was alarmed at first. Had she tied the pontoon down to the wrong dock? This was the one that Julie and the guys had insisted they were supposed to pull up to. And honestly, it did look familiar. The morning felt like it had happened eons ago, but she was quite sure this was the same wooden floating dock they'd trotted down at 9 o'clock that morning. In the off chance she had made a mistake, she didn't want to seem guilty and hurry away. She walked to the dock and waited as the man in the little boat pulled in on the other side.
"Is this the wrong dock?"
she asked, afraid of the answer. If she had to untie her perfect knot, She might just throw a tantrum.
I'm not really out here all that much, and my friends told me this was the right one.
Oh no, this isn't my dock,
the man said with cheer in his voice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.